kind enough to let me be involved. And we're getting books to a lot of kids. And Alan, you got one zone too. And he's almost learned to read. We're very proud of him. Right now he's at the same spot. That's all we got. You guys do the hard work. The Broncos. You guys do all the hard work. Which I am just so grateful.
I get all the credit.
You guys, honestly, the credit belongs to you. Everybody who's done so much hard work just to make this thing work and just to get books to kids. I still read. I do a lot of goofy things. But I read about it first. So I don't get shocked electrically.
I think Nathan really fits it all. You know, PJ, Brain, Kyle, Nathan, you guys.
Our phone number is 323-658-6047. And our website's pretty easy. It's goldenapplecomics.com. That's C-O-M-I-C-S, no X. And we're on Twitter, Facebook, and all that good stuff.
Thank you so much for talking and being so supportive of the community.
Anytime.
Well, hi, I'm Steve Ray. I'm the MC for tonight's show, Dr. Horrible, and the Guild screenings, which are being held at the Regency Theater here in North Hollywood. It's sponsored by the Fandom Charities Incorporated in Whedonopolis, which is a project to feed Fandom Charities. Fandom Charities is a nonprofit group that provides content and events for fans of Joss Whedon and other shows and celebrities connected with him. And we raise money for charity. So all the money that's raised tonight is going to an organization called Kids Need to Read, which was founded by Nathan Fillion, the star of Castle and Firefly, among others, and G.J. Harden, who is a writer and is a good friend of Nathan. Together they started this. It's a great charity that raises money and then buys books to go to disadvantaged schools and provide reading opportunities and learning opportunities for children who have school. So we're glad to do this for them, and we're glad to do this for the fans of Nathan and DJ and Joss Whedon and everybody else connected in this, what we call the Joss Whedon.
So is this the first year that you're the MC?
No, I tend to do this MC activity for the group. Everybody in the group has things that they do. We all work as a team. This happens to be something I tend to specialize in.
So, are you a big fan of Dr. Horrible?
Oh, yeah. I've seen it many times. Every time we do this, I get to see it again. And I'm a fan of the actors in it. Has Nathan Fillion, Neil Patrick Harris, Felicia Day, who is a great person. She's also the creator and star of The Guild, which is the other show that we show here on Whedonopolis tonight. So it's we've become great fans of these, and over this period of time, we've become friends with these people, too. They're just fantastic people. We're happy to do this and raise money for charities that not only they support, but they support.
So how long have you been with the nonprofit that helps to oversee this group? You had mentioned that you're the legal counsel.
Well, the group started as kind of an unformed committee, as it were, that began working together, and over a period of time, we felt it was best to incorporate. So we incorporated in the state of California. We applied to the Internal Revenue Service for nonprofit status. We achieved that, and now every dollar we raise goes directly to the charity, because we are a totally nonprofit, non-paid volunteer group of people doing this. So we take no money from it. All the money raised goes directly to the charity.
Wow. So if someone wanted to help out with donations or attending the events, do you have upcoming events on your website?
Yes, we have it's Whedonopolis, that's in Joss Whedon, Whedonopolis, Whedonopolis.com. If they go to that, they can find the activities that we're involved in. They can get involved with us. We also do a lot of reporting. For instance, at Comic-Con every year down in San Diego, we hold the last show at Comic-Con every year. We do Once More with Feeling, which is the musical episode from Buffy the Vampire Slayer, one of Joss Whedon's creations. We've been very successful at that for several years. I think it's about 5 or 6 years we've been doing that. This is our fourth year for doing the Dr. Horrible screening.
Wow, that is great. So how did you start doing volunteer work in conjunction with your background as a lawyer?
Well, primarily through my wife. Isn't that how we all start? Through somebody we know. My wife knew some people involved in this group. She became involved, and she, as she always does, got me involved. Of course, I get her involved in all of the activities that I'm involved with. I have several other nonprofits that I run as well, and so I help her, she helps me. Together we all have a, you know, have a fun time. It's great fun doing this, and it's very rewarding doing this as well.
So will you be going down to the Long Beach Convention also this year?
I'm not planning to myself. I actually have to work every now and then, you know how. And my wife may be making it, but I know other members of this group will.
And they'll be having some sort of event there in Long Beach in that next weekend, correct?
Yes. There's many events going on all over the place, actually. We go to a lot of these events. We sometimes hold events ourselves. Sometimes we just go and attend because we're part of the Fandom universe as well.
Wow, that is great. I'm really looking forward to going to the website and attending future events. Thank you so much for speaking with me.
Well, thank you. And again, it's Whedonopolis.com. Thank you.
Kelly Amore.
Wow, this is a lot of fun. This is my first time attending. So you're a big fan of Dr. Horrible. That's how you came up with the idea to raise funds for children to have books?
Actually, in 07, we did the last Buffy Once More Revealing, officially approved Singalong. And that was for the Elizabeth Grace Pediatric AIDS Foundation. And at that one, they did Fury Days, Edlin,
and now I'm hosting and I'm coming. It's wonderful to get up. I've got here.
Looking very handsome.
Sorry.
Since everyone does it as volunteers, none of us get paid for anything. We don't even get a free pizza when we get together.
We can't even participate in the drawing.
There's a few things that almost disappear.
Yeah.
But people work really hard for this, and it's just something that we love to do. And the volunteers that we've had over the years, we always get a few new ones, really get into the spirit of it all. And it's being done not to become something well-known, for people to give back to the community. Because as the Brown Coat Young South Fraternity, we try to do it with the other parts of the fandom to give back to the world, to fix the world. And this is our little bit of fixing the world.
And this really is a labor of love. Like, we all just do this out of the goodness of our hearts, out of the love for the community, and love of charity work that we do. And everybody just gets so into it. I mean, there's a lot of stress leading up to it, but once we get here tonight and actually start doing it, it's just a blast.
I'd love
it really
the whole
is.
Thing is completely worth it once you get in there and everyone's singing and waving their little curtains and dancing their little horse.
Yeah.
It's completely worth it. Every single penny.
Well, thank you so much for speaking with me and organizing this great event every Halloween season. And I'm looking forward to going into the area to see Dr. Horrible.
All right. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.